Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can create an user account in Active Directory. One of the most common tools used when managing Active Directory is the Active Directory Users and Computers tool, also known as ADUC. Active Directory Users and Computers is a tool that lets you manage user accounts and more. To open Active Directory Users and Computers, click on the Start menu and search for Active Directory Users and Computers. And click on it. And on the left side, you can see the AD domain at the top, along with the containers and organizational units. The organizational units are also referred to as OUs. To create an user account, right-click on the domain in the Active Directory Users and Computers console, select New, and click on User. Now, instead of creating a user account in the Active Directory domain container, it is typically created in the default organizational unit for users, which is called Users. Or you can create a user account in one of the custom OUs that you have created. For example, let's expand the OU called EU, which is for Europe region. Within this OU, you can see additional OUs for servers, users, and workstations. I will right-click on the OU users and select new and click on user. So you're going to see this new object user wizard opening up. Just fill in all the fields that apply to the user, like the first name, last name, and their user logon name. In my case, the first name is Michael, and the last name is Kemper. Also specify the user logon name. This is the logon name that the user will use to log into his or her workstation. I will specify Michael.Kemper as the user logon name. Now, do not forget to select an appropriate domain for the user logon name. And if you're in a multi-domain forest, you might have a few different options for the user logon name. Just make sure to choose the right one based on your domain structure. In my case, I only have one at tastybiryani.local. I will keep that option selected. Whatever you type for the user logon name will also be the same for pre-Windows 2000 user logon name, tastybiryani/michael.kemper. Click on Next to proceed to the next page of the wizard. Now you're on the next page where you can set up the password and then confirm it. Just make sure that the password follows the password policy for your domain. So I'm going to type in the password. There are a few more options that you can set. So the first option is user must change password at next logon, which basically means that the user will be prompted to change their password next time they log in. It's a good idea to make them choose their own password. So I would recommend this option to be checked. The second option is user cannot change password. You would typically select this option for service accounts. However, for a regular user account, you want to keep this option unchecked. In my case, I'm going to leave it unchecked. The third option is password never expires. It is also typically selected for a service account, but not for a regular user account. So I'm going to leave this one unchecked as well. Lastly, the fourth option is account is disabled. You would select this option if the user account is not going to be used right away, like a few days later. But in our case, the user is going to use the user account right away as soon as possible. So I'm going to leave this option unchecked. I'm going to click on Next. All right, now you can take a look at the options that you have selected on the last screen. And if everything is okay, click on Finish to complete the wizard. You can see the user account is now shown in the right pane, labeled as first name and last name. Notice that I had another account created in this OU called Michael Green. This is another employee account. So if you need to change multiple accounts at once, hold down the Control key and click on all the accounts that you want to modify. Right-click on them and click on Properties. This will give you a box where you can set all of the attributes you want for all of the accounts you have selected. There are many options here. You can even set the same description for all of the accounts by checking the box and typing in a description. Same goes for Office attribute or any of the other options. You can then navigate to the other tabs such as Account, Address, Profile, and Organization. In each tab, you'll find numerous attributes you can assign and edit in bulk. I would like to view the properties of the user account that I've just created, so I'm going to click on Cancel, and I'm going to right-click on Michael Kemper and click on Properties. Here, you can see similar tabs, but there are many more, and not all of these tabs show up when you modify the user accounts in bulk mode. If you're using Active Directory, Users, and Computer Snap-in, and if you want to assign additional attributes such as Office or Department, then you have to create the user account first. Now, to change the office, simply add the office name in the office field. In my case, I will specify NY because the location of the user, Michael Kemper, is New York. All right, I will click on OK. OK, so this is how you create a new user account using Active Directory Users and Computers MMC Snap-in. I hope you like this video. For more videos like these, please subscribe to my channel.